By default, your router automatically assigns IP addresses to your devices using a protocol called DHCP, or Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. With DHCP, if you have a device that disconnects from your home network for a while and then reconnects to it, it will automatically receive a new and different IP address. For most devices, this isn't really an issue, but in some cases, you may want a device that has an IP address that never changes. For these situations, you can manually assign a static IP address to that device. That's exactly what we're going to be talking about today in this episode from Network from Home, so let's get started. So what are some of those situations where you want a device to always have the same IP address? Well, for example, if you are hosting online gaming sessions, you need to use port forwarding, and port forwarding only works if your server, whatever is hosting that gaming session, has the same consistent IP address all the time. On top of that, if you're hosting a website, say you have network attached storage or you have a server at home and you're hosting a website on it, you want that IP address to be the same. Otherwise, people that are trying to get to your website won't know where to find it. On top of that, if you have a home security system and you have security cameras, if they have changing IP addresses, that might cause problems with your security system. So in those cases, you want those cameras to have the same IP address all the time. Lastly, if people are accessing a networked printer with its IP address, this is often the case in many office situations, but obviously if that IP address of the printer is changing, people are going to have a lot of problems with printing. So you want that to be the same IP address all the time. When it comes to manually assigning an IP address to one of your devices, there are two different ways of doing it. The first way is by going into the device's settings itself and setting the IP address there. Alternatively, you can change and manually set that IP address in your router settings. Personally, I think it's a lot easier to do in your router settings. You'll get to see what other IP addresses are currently in use by your other devices. It's a lot faster to track your devices and their IP addresses. So that's how I'm going to be showing you how to do it today. Okay, so before we get started and take a look at my router settings, what we need to do is first you need to identify the device that you want to assign the manual IP address to. What you'll need specifically is what's called a MAC address or a Media Access Control address. This is basically just the hardware identifier for that device, and it allows your router to tie an IP address to your physical device. So if you know what your MAC address is, you're good to go. You can move to the next step. Otherwise, if you're not sure what the MAC address is, you can take a look at the device. It might have an informational sticker that lists the MAC address on it. Or alternatively, if you want to assign an IP address to, say, your laptop, you can go into the device's settings and find out the MAC address that way. I'll show you how to do that real quickly, just in case that's what you want to do. All right, here we are on my laptop. One important thing to keep in mind, if you want to assign a manual IP address to a device like your laptop, you'll need to know that there will be a different MAC address if it's going to have a Wi-Fi connection to your router or if it's going to have an Ethernet connection to your router. So depending upon that, that will determine where you need to go in your device's settings. I'll show you where to find both just so all our bases are covered. All right, so let's go into settings here. First, we go into settings. From here on the left-hand side, we want to go to network and internet. And here's where we need to make the distinction in terms of how this laptop will be connected to your router. First, let's look at Wi-Fi. That's probably the most common. We'll select Wi-Fi here. And then we go down to hardware properties. From here, all we have to do is scroll down a little bit. Physical address MAC. Here it is. Here's the physical MAC address for your Wi-Fi connection for your laptop. If we want to see the Ethernet MAC address, let's go back to Wi-Fi. Back to network and internet. Here we'll click Ethernet. And same thing, we're going to scroll down. Physical MAC address, here we go. So now you have the MAC address of either your Wi-Fi or Ethernet connection, however it's going to be connecting to your router. Say there's another device that you want to assign a static IP address to. If it has an interface like a laptop, you just need to find the network settings and it should list the MAC address somewhere in those settings. But first, I want to reiterate that you might want to check the sticker on the device. It might list the MAC address right on it. To identify the MAC address, just keep in mind they're all going to have the same format. It's going to be 12 alphanumeric characters set up just like this. Now that we have the MAC address of the device that we want to assign the static IP address to, we're going to jump right into my router settings. If you're not sure how to do that, I previously made a video about that. I'll link to it up above. Check that out so you can get into your router settings, and then we'll go to the next step. Here we are in my router settings. One thing I want to show you really quickly is how you can identify the MAC address of your device if it's already connected to your router. This might be a faster and easier way than manually going to the device or looking up the device's settings and its configuration. Now again, this depends how the device is connected to your router. For example, my laptop is connected to my router wirelessly. So if we go down here, we see wireless clients. There's 8 listed here. If we click on this, here it lists all the clients, the name of the device, as well as the MAC address of that device. One thing I recommend to everybody, because it makes it a lot easier to manage your home network, is either every time you add a new device to your home network or periodically, you go in and you identify all the devices that are connected to your home network. What's really cool is you can go in here, you can change the names of these devices. So that way you know, okay, all the devices that I know of are connected to my router. It makes it a lot easier to identify devices that might be malicious or that you don't want connected to your home network, just if you stay on top of this. And then of course, if you want to assign a static IP address to one of these devices, it makes it a lot easier because you have a directory here of what all the devices are and accordingly what all their MAC addresses are. So again, in this example, we're assigning my laptop with a static IP address. I've named my laptop Skynet, so I know it's this device. Here's the MAC address, and it checks out with the Wi-Fi MAC address that we looked up earlier. So let's just make a note of this MAC address because we'll need it when we set up the static IP address. With that information in hand, now we can go and assign a static IP address to my laptop. We do that in the advanced section, so go up here to advanced. Before moving forward with a static address for my laptop, I just want to be clear here. Your settings might look different depending upon the make and model of your router, but in general, the steps should be the same. So you should be able to complete these steps similarly to how I'm completing them, regardless of what device you have. With that said, let's go up to the advanced settings. Now there's a little bit of planning that has to take place when we're assigning a static IP address. The first thing we have to look at, let's go to network. LAN, which stands for Local Area Network. All right, this page is really important because it helps you identify the total number of IP addresses that are available for your router to assign to your devices. So here's our router's IP address, 192.168.0.1. The subnet mask is really important because it tells you which of these IP address numbers need to remain the same when assigning static IP addresses. So in other words, this 255.255.255, that means that 192.168.0 all needs to stay the same. From here over, all needs to stay the same when we're assigning IP addresses, but this can change. You can have .1, .2, .3, all the way up to 255. So just keep this in mind. Make note of the subnet mask and IP address of your router, because that will give you the total number of IP addresses available for your devices. This will come into play in the next step here when we account for DHCP IP addresses. To see what IP addresses are being used by DHCP, we need to go in over here, DHCP server. The important takeaway here is the IP address pool that DHCP is using. As I mentioned at the beginning of this video, DHCP is used to automatically assign IP addresses to your devices when they connect to the network, and there's a specific pool of IP addresses that are used to hand out to these devices. Now, it's important to note that this DHCP pool is not all of the available IP addresses that your router can assign. So what we want to do is we want to assign a static IP address that is outside of this DHCP pool. If we assigned an IP address within this DHCP pool, if you have a device that's connecting to your network, your router might try to automatically assign it with that same IP address that you've statically assigned to another address. This will cause a lot of issues, and you can avoid that by assigning a static IP address that is outside of the DHCP IP address pool. So what we need to do in order to identify the available IP addresses we can use for a static IP address, we need to subtract all of the IP addresses that are within this DHCP pool. So as you can see here, the pool starts at 192.168.0.100 and goes to 192.168.0.249. As you'll recall, these three numbers need to remain the same because of the subnet mask of our router. But with our router, it started at 192.168.0.1, and this pool is using from .100 to .249. So basically what this tells us is that 192.168.0.2 up to 192.168.0.99 are available for static IP addresses. So we can pick a random one here. We can pick .2 if we want. We can pick .50 if we want. But that is the available list of IP addresses we can statically assign. So in order to assign a static IP address to my laptop's Wi-Fi connection, address reservation, we go to add. The MAC address we're gonna copy from the previous step. We saw it on my router settings homepage, but we also looked it up in the device's settings itself. Next, we need to assign a static IP address to this laptop. As I mentioned, let's take a look at the list of available static IP addresses. We'll go 192.168.0.50. Description, we're gonna say laptop Wi-Fi. Enable this entry, save. One thing to keep in mind here, this was listed as invalid format, so we may have to put dashes here instead of colons, dash. Okay, that worked, so now we have a static IP address assigned to the Wi-Fi connection for our laptop. One thing that's worth noting here is that if you're going to have a lot of devices with static IP addresses, it's more important to be very structured in how you assign them. You might want to keep track of them in an Excel spreadsheet to make sure that you're not assigning duplicate IP addresses. But if you're only assigning one device with a static IP address, like I am here, the IP address isn't as important and you don't really have to worry about which one you choose. Now for some devices, when you statically assign the IP address, you'll need to restart it in order for the changes to take place. But at this point, we've statically assigned this IP address to my laptop and we're good to go. I'd love to see in the comments section if you're using static IP addresses, what you're using them for. And if you learned something new and you're able to implement a static IP address because of this video, I would appreciate it if you give it a like. As always, thanks for checking out this episode from Network From Home, and we'll catch you on the next one.